Hi guys, welcome to Mirake the Tribe. My name is Ayushi and this is going to be for the sign of Virgo. So this is a December reading and this is going to apply for Virgo, Sun, Moon and Rising. So let's see what's coming up for Virgo for the month of December. Sun, Moon and Rising. What is coming up for Virgo for December 2018? Sun, Moon and Rising. Virgo, December 2018, Sun, Moon and Rising. Virgo, Sun, Moon, Rising, general monthlies for December 2018. Messages for Virgo. So let's see what's coming up for you. Now I'll cut the deck. So the first card out for you is the Four of Wands. So this is the heart of the matter for you, Virgo. Challenging you is Ten of Swords. The root of the reading, Six of Pentacles. Past, the Devil card. What's on your mind? Eight of Swords. In future, Two of Wands. How you come up, Magician. Your surroundings, Six of Wands. Your hopes and fear, Ace of Pentacles. Your outcome, Seven of Cups. I'll clarify the outcome. Clarifiers, one of this is Virgo card, which is Mother of Pentacles. So, bottom of the deck is the Moon card, which is the Pisces card. Okay. You can be dealing with the Pisces Sun, Moon, Rising and let's see. I have a lot of cards on this table. I just kept pulling out more cards because your reading was coming out very, you know, like you are very confused. So even though you come up as Magician here, people see you like you have so much going on in your life, you can do so much in your life, but what I see is that you consider yourself stuck. You feel you are not able to move and you are thinking about few things, like certain sort of questions. And that's why the kind of questions that you are putting yourself, like, you know, you're thinking about, that's keeping you stuck. Now, because the root of this reading is the Six of Pentacles, obviously, I'm feeling here that there was something imbalanced or there was something at the core which was not balanced in a way that, by the way, it has been clarified by the Temperance and the Chariot. So temperance is again about the balance. So what's bothering you is that you want to invest in something and you probably are not getting the results for that. Like you have to keep your patience with the results. Okay, you want some stability, but there is a certain sort of a betrayal. Like you want a commitment, a very strong commitment with somebody, but what's hindering you is either you're feeling betrayed or this person has betrayed you. So some, like, the core of this reading is a certain sort of commitment that you need or you want, or you were hoping for, but there has been some betrayal. The card that was clarifying the betrayal card is this card. Actually, there are two cards that clarified it: the Ten of Wands and the Five of Cups. So whatever betrayed you obviously left you in a very sad situation here, and you feel very burdened. Both of these are 10-10. So you felt very burdened, you felt sad. Now I'm also getting here that someone wants security, someone wants healing, someone wants stability, someone wants a commitment. But whatever happened in the past, they are still crying over it, they are still sad about it, they are still feeling the burden of the past. So they still have to go through that healing, and they still have to build a foundation for themselves. And these three cards came out in the same spot. All these cards are four. So number four is very important for your December, month of December. So number four is about stability, groundedness, feeling safe. So yes, four is about house, security. So I'm getting that either you, some of you will be saving money in the month of December to build a house, to buy a house, or to for your peace of mind, basically. But you will be constantly feeling very burdened and emotionally drained at the same time, and that's coming up as your challenge. Now on your mind, like I said, you are feeling very stuck. In your head, you have a lot of questions and things that you are dealing with. But these two cards are clarifying it. So either you are dealing with a Gemini or a Leo Sun Moon Rising, or Gemini Sun Moon Rising. Or a Leo person or a fire sign has to choose between two people. And somebody is either choosing a fire sign. If someone has to make a choice between two people, then someone is choosing a very bold person, someone who is very good looking, charismatic, someone is who is very confident. What can also be confusing you is if you have a choice between two people. You are dealing with somebody who is very charismatic. Also, I'm getting that in December, you will have some options, and if you want to really make a life-changing decision in your life in the month of December, then to make that decision, you need to follow your heart, you need to follow your dreams, your passion. So this is a card of choice. This is a life-changing choice. Does not have to be choice between two people. It can be making a choice about how can I live my life in a more beautiful way. What you have to do is move from this space, this mental space, to this space where here you are surrounded by a lot of self-doubt and confusion and anxiety, basically here. You're feeling burden which are not even there. You are just not living in present. You are living in past or future. So you are stressing yourself out. So in order to make a life-changing choice, you need to be in this mental state where you are very confident, bold, and you know, very much self-reliant and not needing approval of other people. This person basically doesn't give a damn. And in past, you have the devil. So you got rid of something which was toxic because it's in past. So either you were dealing with a Capricorn person, or you were tied to somebody who was toxic, or a situation which was not serving you. It was burning all your four corners of stability. So if you wanted some sort of a concrete decision, if you wanted a concrete answer, or you wanted to know where you stand in with somebody, this is the stability card basically. So if you wanted to know about where you are standing with a person or in a situation, you were not able to make you were not able to understand where I truly stand in this entire situation, what should I do, and what kind of this is a lifestyle which is not working out for you. So but that's in past, so you have realized that it was not working out for you, so you are doing away with it. It's just that you are finding it very hard to move away from it, because like I said, you are in this mental space, and you need to be in this mental space where you need to have your basically you need to have your shit together. And the devil is being clarified by the Mother of Cups, so it can be also a water sign, or somebody who was very emotional or selflessly giving, mothering, and someone who shares emotions, listens to you, someone who is very easy to talk to. They can talk on they can help you navigate emotions. So either you can be dealing with that sort of person, or this person could be a healer. Either you were a hope for this person, or this person was a hope for you. There was some healing involved. So in past there was some healing that you have probably done with respect to a toxic situation. I'm also getting that in past there was some conflict that is now over, but it was a very bitter conflict, and you need to heal that situation, or you have already done that. Okay, you can also be dealing with the Aquarius Sun Moon rising in the past. Now let's see what's coming up in your future. So in your future, Virgo, you are looking forward because you know that you have accomplished something and you have not accomplished something. So whatever you have accomplished, you are taking that with you. You are thinking about it, what I have accomplished and what more I need to accomplish. So you are basically giving it a thought, where do I go from here? And you are considering your options. Your clarifiers are Nine of Wands and the Ace of Swords. So in future, I see that you are fighting for something with all of your energy. You're fighting for something, and it can also be that you are fighting for truth, or you're fighting for clarity. Okay, or it can also mean that you're defending yourself with some sort of sharpness, like you are very sharp and you are defending your path, or you are standing true in your path. That's what I'm getting here, and it is taking you a lot of courage to stand in your true self and true divine path. It is also saying that you might be feeling like I have been fighting this battle for such a long time, and I still feel that you still have some fight left in you. So you're still going to give it your last try because it's 9 of wands and not 10 of wands. However, I'm also getting that don't stress yourself too much in this situation, because 10 of wands was your challenge card. So it can mean that you are burdening yourself with a lot of responsibilities and you need some clarity of thought. You need to clear your mind basically in order to make a decision where you need to move forward. Now, Ace of Swords is also about speaking what you truly mean and not saying something that you do not mean. It can also mean that you will have an idea in future which you will explore with all your strength. You are giving it your all, and it can be an old idea that comes up again in your life and you are wanting to pursue that dream or that idea. You want to make it real. Now, how you come up in this reading, like I already said, as the magician. So people see you as a magician, like you have so much going on in your life and you have so much to accomplish, you have so much to manifest, and you can do so many things with the resources that you have. But the clarifiers are the Six of Swords and the Hermit. So you do have a lot of inner knowledge and awareness, and you want to move away from a place where you were feeling conflicted or you were feeling mental turmoil. So you do go within to look for your answers, and from within you are trying to get some idea or some resource which is within you. You're trying to bring that into a literal, you know, a living form. It can also mean that some of you are traveling to some place where you can find some space to just for yourself, like a pleasant space or a cozy space. I'm also getting that you will be sitting alone and doing your work, some big work. It's not like random work, it's a big work that you want to manifest, and you will sit alone and do it. This work requires some peace and isolation, so it needs some peace of mind, and you need to move away from conflict to do this work that you want to bring to reality. Now, in your surrounding there is some recognition, victory and some success. So this can be you reaping rewards for your effort, or this can be somebody around you who is being recognized, who is being celebrated. In your surrounding, luck has a huge role to play. So no matter what you are doing, you will have a wish fulfillment due to your fate, because these two cards are coming together. So you might get recognition, and your luck is with you because you have wish fulfillment card, like all your wishes coming true, feeling very fulfilled, satisfied and emotionally really good, and feeling very recognized, and you know, like getting reward for the work that you have done. Now, your hopes and fears is Ace of Pentacles. So you are hoping for something stable, new to come your way, like an opportunity which upon which you want to build something new. It can be a job, you're waiting for a job opportunity, or it can be a fear, like you fear that you will not do so well when this opportunity comes up in your life, and you are not going to be, you might probably be feeling that what if I miss this opportunity. It can also mean that you are afraid of starting something new from the scratch. That is also coming up. Your clarifiers are Sun of Pentacles and the Sun card. So what I'm getting here is that there is no need to have fear, because once you will decide to dedicate yourself and grab this opportunity that is being presented to you by the universe. Once you start building upon this opportunity by putting your head down and being dedicated to that work, it can be a little boring for a while because this is Sun of Pentacles, then you'll have to go to Knight of Pentacles, then you will become the King of Pentacles. It can be a little bit slow, but you have to do the work. You will have to build on this new something that you will get in the month of December, and it will lead to success and prosperity and happiness and abundance. This is the card that you are getting with it. So good luck with that. And then we have the outcome card. Your outcome card was the Neptune card, and this is Seven of Cups. So by the end of the month, you are in a very in a very Disney sort of a land, like Disneyland, fantasy land. I'm not saying in your head, I'm feeling it's more like New Year celebration or the 25th of December sort of celebration. So you are not in reality, you are probably enjoying yourself, but the clarifier is this, that you are at home or at peace, or you're dealing with a Taurus, Virgo, Capricorn, or you're with family or some maternal figure, or a feminine energy is around you which is taking care of you or nurturing you, or you are nurturing somebody. It can mean that you are lavishly treating yourself in a way that you're treating yourself lavishly, and some sort of glamour is coming up here. Like there is some glamour at domestic place. That's what I'm getting. There can be some deception as well at this place. So if you're dealing with a Virgo, Taurus, Capricorn, Sun, Moon, Rising, there can be a lot of options, or you have a lot of options and you're recognizing that I have a lot of options. Another clarifier is the Judgment card. Judgment card is a Scorpio card. This can mean that you are leaving something behind completely, like for the last time you're purging. This year is final, the year is wrapping up, and I'm rising above something that has been probably keeping me down. It can be a heartbreak where you felt really sad and depressed. All the burdens that you were carrying, all the heart betrayal that you faced, and all the questions that you have been asking yourself over and over again. So I'm getting that you will leave all that behind and forgive the 2018 entire year. You will just forget everything that did not serve you and take the lesson and move forward, because here you are in your element, sitting with a lot of options, and anything that is coming your way is something which is like a huge opportunity and a good possibility upon which you can build basically. And then your bottom of the deck energy is these cards. So those of you who are looking for love, there is some mystery in love, or you're dealing with a Pisces or a Taurus person, Sun, Moon, Rising. There can be someone juggling two people, or this person is probably I'm not actually getting juggling two people, but someone is probably juggling like places. This person keeps moving around, or this person is doing multitasking, like this person is multitasking, or you are just looking for a situation where your love is reciprocated. And Empress card, so feeling very abundant, like I said, like either you're dealing with a maternal figure, so that can also be the case. Like you are getting I'm even going to say that I'm feeling that even if you are a girl, I'm getting that you are getting support from your girlfriends and even boys. Like you're getting a lot of attention from a female figure who is treating you in a very nurturing way. So that was your reading, Virgo. I'll pull out a oracle card. So give me a message for Virgo. December 2018, message for Virgo. Guys, if I speak really slow, then you can, speed the video if you can. You know, you can go into the setting and speed up the video. Some of you have to write your plan down. I think I'm getting this again for the Virgo. Earlier also, I think we got the same card. The word wants to be written. The word wants to be written and new birth guarded vigilantly. So there is something new that is going to start, and you need to plan things out in a very strategic manner. And I am also getting some of you need to work on your intention setting. Now, what is intention setting? You will have to Google that. How can I set intention? So there is a lot of journaling that is done to manifest the things that you want in your life. So one blockage for Virgo. One blockage card for Virgo for December. This is your blockage. So some of you are having a face to face, you are having to face your destiny. There was something that you wanted, you're not getting it, or you will get something that you did not know like you wanted, but you will get it. And you should know how to treat it. Like if it's a gift, it's a blessing, then you need to thank the universe for it. And if you are facing your destiny and things are not working out for you, be assured that it's happening for your good. And I know it doesn't sound nice, but it feels like you will be saved from something that you might not know about. Something better is waiting for you. And destiny card was also there in your spread. So you are right now very much affected by your destiny, and in a way that there is not much that you can do to control the result. You can only do what you can do, and you should let the result be whatever the result be. Result can be anything, but you need to focus on your work. So the work that you are putting in, you need to be focused on that. And the bottom of the deck is the impatience card. So if you are being impatient about something, you want something now, try to have some control over that. You need to be really patient with what you get and how you manage the things that you already have. Let things grow, don't rush things, and be patient, because what else will you do? You need to stand by yourself. You cannot stand against yourself by being impatient. You can't afford it. Can you? If you can afford being impatient, be impatient. It is not going to solve anything. It's only going to complicate things. It is going to put you in an anxiety mode. So it's better that you just do your work and let it be, and don't expect anything. Buddha told us that expectation is cause of misery. That's a very simple and a very popular statement. So don't expect anything. Just keep on doing your work and enjoy all the things that comes along, and just be patient. Things will turn in your favor, not now but soon. Okay, happy new year, and I'll see you again.